Hi, how are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm fine. I'm Anna.
Hey, Anna. I'm Jackson. Good to meet you.
Come on in. The moment I saw Jackson, my heart lifted. It was like Superman had arrived.
So, we have a cat problem?
People have called him the psycho cat. Max is my cat. He's 8 years old. He's been with me since he's 8 weeks old. And he's a ragdoll.
Oh, he's a ragdoll?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, ragdolls are known to be mild-tempered cats. They actually go limp when you pick them up. They're not known to be aggressive at all. So I was really intrigued to see what would make a normally docile cat so ferocious.
When you call him psycho cat, is he more psycho than he is not psycho?
Not with me necessarily, but when other people are around.
It's anybody but her.
When was the last attack that happened?
That was this morning with me. He bit me in the hand.
These are all bites?
Yep, that's a one from one bite.
That's pretty bad looking. Did you clean that up?
Yeah, I'm a firefighter paramedic, so I can clean all this stuff up.
Yeah, you know what you're doing.
But I'm very standoffish from him because every time I'm here, he's angry. I don't like being around the cat. I don't.
Wow, Chris is a firefighter, and even he's scared to deal with Max. How bad is this cat?
So you are still holding on to Max. You're not letting go.
No, I'm all he's got, and I don't want to give up on him.
Right.
I love Max, you know, I do. My kids grew up with their Nona being very involved in their lives, and
sure.
I want to be that for my grandchildren.
But don't say your family comes first if the cat comes first. Do something with the cat, either fix him or find a kitty farm somewhere.
I look over to Anna, and she looks tortured.
My mom, she said, well, why don't you come on over for dinner? And it's like, we can't, we got the kids.
Yeah.
And she's like, well, bring the kids with you, not with that cat around.
We're at the point that since your two kids have been on this planet, you haven't been here for dinner.
No.
That's like anti-Italian, you can't do that.
It's pretty simple, you know, either the cat changes or we don't bring the kids around.
I feel horrible for Anna because for the love of her cat, they've basically isolated her, and that's a problem on so many levels, not just for Anna and her well-being, but for Max's as well.
Let's get up and start walking around, okay?
Okay.
Now, the first place I wanted to go was the most important place in an Italian home, and that's the kitchen.
Tell me exactly where you'd be worried about.
Christopher likes to just walk in the kitchen.
Christopher is your older
son.
Your older son?
And I would imagine Max here.
Because you'd be cooking?
Yeah.
That means Max here.
Right.
And he's just, he's here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Cats are territorial, so we have to make a safe environment so that Chris's son's presence doesn't make Max feel threatened. At the same time, his son's gotta feel safe to explore his Nona's house.
You guys hang out, I'll be back, all right?
All right.
In order to do that, it's time for me to spend a little bit of time with Max.
Oh God, oh God.
Hope he doesn't lose a limb.
Oh God.
Where are you, Max? Max? Where are you, man? Well, hi. Oh, God, man. When he just flew by my face and out there, I'm telling you, my heart skipped a beat. Hey, hey, where are you going, buddy? Where are you going? All right, Max. Come on, buddy. It's okay, buddy. What about this close? Are you okay? Bye bye. Come on, mister. Oh, don't go back up there again. Let's go. This way.
Ow! Ow, ow, ow! Ow! Ow!
This cat has some muscle behind him. When he hit me, it hurt.
You're like a boxer.
Come on. Ah, come on, Max. Okay. All right, dude. I pushed Max enough for one day, and I've seen enough at this point.
Max, buddy, I'm gonna leave you alone now.
And I'm gonna get out of this room before I get bit.
Bye, Max.
Okay, guys. Max is clearly agitated with my presence. He was hissing at me a lot. His growling is pretty menacing. He's a big cat.
Max is out of control.
Ow!
It's completely unacceptable. And if she doesn't take action, I'm gonna take action. And my action is I'm not bringing my family or myself over here to see my mom.
You guys ready for some homework?
Okay.
Now, the first thing I want to talk about is block off unders and build up. I want him up in places where he's going to feel a little more strength. I want to encourage the vertical world for Max. That way, we can get Max up feeling like he's safe, not trapped. Hopefully, I'm walking in here today where we can have a big family gathering at the end of the day. So my fingers are crossed on this one.
Hi, Jackson.
Hey, Chris. Good to see you, man.
Good to see you.
How are things going here?
Well, I've had people come in and out several times. And Max will just, you know, sit and watch people on his own.
That's amazing.
I didn't have to drag him out.
And now he's, you know, just kind of cruising around and not really too worried about what's going on around him.
Hi, baby.
That's all the work that we've been doing here. Now, our goal here today was to bring over your wife and kids. Are your nerves bigger than your sense of optimism?
I feel okay with what's going on with him right now, but I'm still a little leery. Not only does Max have to earn people's trust, I think people have to earn his trust too.
We want to make sure that we're staying positive about the experience today, but I think we have a lot of reason to be positive. So come on, let's get food ready for everybody coming over.
Okay.
I just want to see Max in the same room as us, not fearful. I don't want him running away. I don't want him running at anyone. I don't want to see any aggression. Very simple. And if that can happen, brilliant. We're done. Success.
Hi.
Hi, Dad.
Come on in.
Hi.
Say hi, Nona.
Hi, baby.
I'm Jackson.
Hi, Jessica.
You gotta remember, Jessica's not been over to this house since she was pregnant with her first child because of Max's violence. I am sweating bullets. My fingers are crossed. I'm just hoping things are gonna go well. You look pretty calm about everything, actually. Are you?
Yes, because Max isn't out right now.
So I send Anna into the bedroom to bring him out, sit with him on the couch for a second, see if we can get him to be a part of this. Anna, how are you feeling over there?
We're doing good here. Max is purring.
Wow. I was not expecting that. Of course, it wouldn't be me if we didn't push this just a little bit. And I'd love for you to come on and join us.
Hi to Max.
He's on the couch.
Yeah.
Seriously, look at him. Look at him. I am so excited to see him sitting. How are you feeling?
I'm pretty shocked.
I'm sitting right next to Christopher. He's making some serious noise. He's making like a symphony with his silverware. It's loud, he's talking. And Max just is hanging out. He's not going anywhere. That is worth the price of admission right there. It's pretty amazing, yeah?
Yeah, very. With all this noise, I'm really amazed he's still there.
It's nice being able to see him out and comfortable, and he seems pretty relaxed right now.
Jackson would have to be a miracle worker to pull it off. Well, it looks like he has, because now my children can come over here, my wife will come over here, and not have to worry about the psycho cat coming out clawing you in the eye when you're not looking.
All I wanted was to have Max in the same room with you guys. Baby sounds galore going on. He's just hanging out there. We got it. And I'm gonna leave you guys, okay? Have a wonderful rest of your night.
Thank you very much.
You're totally welcome. It was great to meet you.
Pleasure.
I feel really secure walking out of here today because this is mission accomplished. Max is not attacked at all because of all the work that Anna and Chris put into this, blocking off and building up so that Max couldn't corner himself, play, and inviting people into Anna's circle and bursting that bubble of protection. We got to where we are today.